Right. That's it's harder for him. He's going to go from never getting hit to getting hit 9 times and sacked 4 times a game.
Well, he's expected to be the first overall pick in the draft next year, which means he'll probably be a New York Jet. And he told Dan Patrick that he is ready to embrace the challenge of playing for a team that's not very good.
I know some of this stuff I say sounds cliche, but just to have the opportunity to go somewhere, help someone rebuild if that's what it is, or whatever, and just win. That's what, you know, something I love doing. I think that's what I'm best at is winning. You know, regardless of stats, whatever it is, that's what I love. So just to have that chance, obviously some places it'll be more of a challenge than others, but I think I'm up for it. And that'll get here when it's here. Just trying to focus now on being great where I'm at.
He also said he doesn't want to completely shut any door when he was asked if he's 100% leaving Clemson. I don't anticipate that he is going to stay. Clemson would be a very poor decision.
Trevor, just go to college. I mean, Joe Burrow was having a great year at Cincinnati. I know he got hurt, but just go to pros. Don't stay in college. It's a huge... Andrew Luck...
It's a massive risk, and for what?
He is probably... I told you I saw him at a camp in San Diego 3 years ago. He was a high school senior. And he was the most impressive thrower of the football I've ever seen in high school. It was in San Diego at Steve Clark's camp.
Trevor Lawrence.
And he was a Southern kid with this rock star hair. And they had all these kids from California.
Sunshine.
Yeah. And he was throwing the football. And it was remarkable for a high school player. He was so effortlessly great. And I remember telling the guy that ran the camp, I'm like, he's not the highest rated one. He's like, he's the best one.
When you look at the Jets situation, it's really not, obviously they're terrible.
Cap space.
They have cap space.
Ton of picks.
They have a ton of picks. They're going to get a new coach. It's not the worst situation to go to.
No, it's not. Jags is way worse.
And guess what? Next year, the team that's picking atop the draft, if you stay in college another year, they're going to be bad too. Because that's what happens.
Also,
that's how you get to the top of the draft.
You're going
to
have a larger field of top candidates be interested because of Trevor Lawrence's talent. So you're going to get some guys who wouldn't take the job with a Sam Darnold, will take it now and apply for it. Big-time college guys.
I'm very excited to see what he does in the NFL. And I'm excited for this draft also.
Oh, God, yes. Oh, I can't.
This year's draft was one of the most... Obviously, it was extremely memorable because of everything that was going on. But on top of it being the only live thing that we had to watch, it really ended up being a great draft.
Okay, so let's go right. Here's the draft order for our radio audience. You can't see this, but Jets would take Trevor Lawrence. Jags would take the Ohio State quarterback, Justin Fields. Bengals probably take the Oregon left tackle, Penei Sewell, and move Jonah Williams' left tackle over to right to protect Burrow. It's not terrible. Chargers would love that left tackle. Chargers probably have to go the kid from Penn State, the linebacker. They Derwin James is hurt too much. They need a leader defensively in the middle of that defense. And the Cowboys probably get an anchor defensively up front.
The Cowboys and the Bengals are the most interesting in the top five to me, because if the Cowboys don't take a quarterback, they need a lot of players.
Yeah.
So they could move, and the Bengals could move as well.
Panthers probably take a quarterback in a perfect situation. The mature Teddy Bridgewater for a year or two is your mentor. That's very Alex Smith and Mahomes.
So they went all defenses
last year. So this year they probably get a quarterback and just say, sit behind a pro, Teddy Bridgewater for 2 years. That Matt Rhule situation is going to work.
Yeah.
Carolina's on their way to being really interesting in about 2 years.
So the Steelers have lost back-to-back games and don't look like the same team that started winning 11 straight. But Roethlisberger doesn't want anyone to panic about the way the offense has been playing recently.
There's a lot of outside noise, right? And deservedly so. We haven't played well. We've lost 2 in a row. The fans are getting anxious. The talking heads are doing what they're supposed to do and talk bad about us and all that stuff, which is, you know, we've earned it and deserved it recently. What I would tell guys in the mindset and the approach that I'm taking is it's not the end of the world. We've got 3 games left in the regular season. We have 3 weeks now to get it going, to turn it around, to give ourselves the best chance to reach our ultimate goal, which is winning a Super Bowl.
I love being a talking head. Don't you love being a talking head?
I do.
It makes me so happy.
I'm just a head that's talking.
I love being a talking head. Well, the last 3 weeks of the season look like this for the Steelers. They have the Bengals this week on Monday night, which obviously we also
That's a Monday night game?
Yeah.
What a cruddy Monday night game that is.
Then the Colts and Steelers. Which could go either way.
Colts and Browns, you mean?
No, Colts. It's Steelers, Bengals, and Colts, Steelers.
Yeah.
And then Steelers, Browns is week 17.
I think Cleveland today is better than Pittsburgh. I really do.
They're certainly playing better than yeah, Pittsburgh. I think if they play today, the Steelers win. But, like, if they played this week, I think the Steelers would win.
I do not.
Well, here's the issue with the Steelers. Well, there's multiple issues with this. There's lots of issues with the Steelers. They had big-time injuries. Devin Bush, Bud Dupree.
Huge.
They can't rush the ball.
Nope.
They have 68 total rushing yards in their two losses. So that right there is a glaring issue. Everyone knows that you have to have an active run game if you're going to win in this league. You can't just rely on Big Ben throwing it 70 times a game. But the other major issue, and this is also playing into why there are so many drops, is everyone knows he can't throw over the top.
Right.
So he's averaged 6.8 yards per attempt this season, seventh fewest among 35 qualified quarterbacks this season, 6.8 air yards this season. They've dropped 10 passes in their two losses, 6 against Washington and 4 against the Bills.
God.
Because he can't throw it over the top and no one's afraid of the long ball, the defense crowds up and just suffocates. And that's on top of, I think, that they have a real focus problem right now. That's why they're dropping so many balls.
It's funny. I watch that offense and I'm like, I am stunned by smart people in the media watching that. And Buffalo did not have a great defense. Thinking that is a Super Bowl offense. I think they're, I've said before, I'm not sure they're a top 10 team. I know it's disrespectful, but when Ben was in his prime, they never felt quite buttoned up. Now they've lost two linebackers. They can't run. He can't throw deep. Even watching their highlights, I'm like, that is not a Super Bowl offense.
I think even with the injuries, their defense is still in good shape. They've got to figure out the running game situation. Yeah. Like the next, just do that against the Bengals. Just run the ball. Figure out how to get that established again, because you're going to need that in the playoffs. Finally, Cam Newton has not had the season he or the Patriots were hoping for so far, but Brian Flores is not underestimating Cam ahead of their game on Sunday. He said, I think he's a very good player in this league. I think he does a really good job extending plays. I think his ability to scramble is something that you always have to take into consideration on every snap. I think he's a leader. I think he's a problem.
This is
very,
my bet
very
of the week.
Very Belichickian of Brian Flores.
I'm not saying which way I'm going. This is my bet of the week in Blazing 5.
So it is in Blazing 5. We all know how Bill Belichick is against rookies. He's 21-5 against rookie quarterbacks with the Patriots, including the playoffs, and 8-0 against rookie quarterbacks since 2015. Obviously, Cam does not have the throwing game that he once had, but he is still a huge issue running the ball. Miami is 22nd in rush yards allowed per game and 18th in passing yards.